I'm going to call the Curriculum Program Committee meeting to order and especially thank all of you who came here. And as you can see, we have a very light committee tonight, so we're not going to be able to take action. But I particularly want to thank Sarah and Jackie for coming. We will probably abbreviate some of the reports a little bit and do more at the full board meeting, but we want to be sure that you have a chance to hear what the staff has prepared. And thank you to the staff. Many of you have been here for over an hour sitting and waiting. I know that. So thank you for your time and thank you for the work that you've done. First item is approval of minutes, and that'll be delayed until the next meeting when we have a quorum. Item B is being pulled from the agenda. Item C, adding boys and girls lacrosse. Dr. Manji.
Madam Chairman, Steve Connect is here to respond to this. Steve?
We have a proposal.
Bueller.
We have a proposal here that has been asked to consider having lacrosse added. I am recommending that we go to the board to not add it at this time for boys and girls lacrosse, but to pursue more education in the role of lacrosse in our state.
Are there any questions or comments? Sarah?
Is lacrosse, I believe Mahone is offering lacrosse as a intramural as an exploration. Is that something that we could though see as part of this?
We're not changing what already exists. They're looking to become a WIA sport, but there is no WIA sport.
Any other questions or comments? Okay, thank you. Then we'll move to the next item, discontinuing middle school membership within the Wisconsin Interscholastic Athletic Association. Dr. Manji.
Mr. Connect.
Hello. There is 680 schools that are junior high and middle school members. 62 of those schools are WIA members. I'm looking to remove our middle schools, five middle schools from the WIA, not changing anything athletically, but it would change the mass restrictions on our middle school and junior high athletes, and it would increase a cost picked up by my budget for catastrophic insurance fee.
Any questions or comments? Anything? Okay, got your recommendation. Thank you. Next item on the agenda, the implementation of the Next Gen Science Standards, Phase 2. Dr. Manji.
Dr. Sue and Chris Pratt are here to answer any questions.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Again, Chris Pratt is here, Coordinator of Science, and she is along with many members of the committee, and Sarah is also a member of the committee sitting up here. So again, thank you on behalf of the group tonight for being here and part of potentially a presentation. The team was planning to really do a very nice educated update, providing very helpful information to help the board make a decision regarding to approve the next generation science standards or to continue utilizing the current standards that we've been operating under. And I appreciate that you're sharing. We'll get an opportunity to do that in front of the full board because it's very, very informational with all the research that's out there. And again, Chris is here if you have specific questions to respect the committee members that are here this evening. But the presentation was pretty powerful.
Any questions? Or Chris, did you want to give an overview or does that sum up?
That sums it up very well.
Okay.
If there are any questions right now, I can answer those.
Okay. Jackie.
I just have one question, and it doesn't matter to me whether you answer tonight or just it's something that, you know, is addressed at the board meeting level. But, you know, I did look into the information that's out there right now on the next generation science standards. And the only part that really troubled me was that Thomas B. Fordham Institute study that gave the NGSS a C grade, and it gave certain states, you know, I know we got an F, but there were states that got an A, you know, so the thought is there, like, why don't we model a state that's getting an A rather than a C? But then I've also heard from people that maybe that study didn't really correlate with how the kids are doing on ACT scores and such. So I guess that's the part that I'd like to hear fleshed out a little more. I mean, are these truly rated a C in the grand scheme of the states, or was the Thomas Fordham study in some way flawed?
We actually spent one of our meetings going over the study itself, and we actually studied that report at one of our meetings at length, and I put some slides in the presentation describing the study, how they came up with their grade, and the implications of that. I didn't include the information that I found on the ACT alignment, but I could I can add that to the presentation for the board meeting, if that's acceptable.
Chris, can you give a little overview that it was only a nine-member team, that one slide that you had, and it was, they set their own criteria?
Right. The three things that were just a little bit in question about that report was that it was just a nine-person team. They set their own criteria. And they traditionally grade standards based on how comprehensive the list of content is, and they don't really get into those process skills. And we know there's a lot of research out there now saying that the process skills really are the key to getting kids college and career ready, especially performing on the ACT. So I'll bring a sample question so that you can see what the ACT is asking for, and we'll address that at length in the report.
Thank you.
Sure.
Sarah?
And interestingly, there are two states that the Fordham Institute gave an A to their standards and two that they gave a B, and all four of those states have adopted the NGSS. So that's kind of telling also.
And I just would like to point out, we had Dr. Angela Anderson here from K-Tech as well with members of her staff, because they are using the next generation science standards. So we were going to, you know, hopefully do a powerful presentation to show exactly what Sarah's talking about and other members of the schools and the teachers in the community. So thank you.
Any other questions about that item? Okay, there will be then a full presentation to the board, and if you have questions, please submit them so we'll be sure that they get answered at that time. So just email through Dr. Manji, and we'll be sure that any of the questions are answered from other people as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Information items, middle school science and social studies honors distinction update. Dr. Manji.
Dr. Sue and Chris and Mark Kinterberg is in the back. So, Mark, if you could come forward, please.
Thank you, Madam Chair, members of the committee. This is an informational update, as is. It's been a request that we bring an update regarding the honors, middle school science and social studies piece. And so Chris and Mark have been spearheading that and did a survey and just maybe some brief highlights.
When we first rolled out the honors distinction idea, we went to each middle school and we took several documents with us to share with them, things to help them plan, things to help them report out, communicate to parents. We wanted to study how well that went, so we did a survey. We let them use them for a year, and then we did a survey of all of those teachers, asking them, how did it go, what kinds of activities did you do, et cetera, et cetera. We gathered a couple of samples, and we outlined in our report several of the findings. The two most significant ones are we need to increase the amount of students who are taking advantage of this by better connecting it to the curriculum, really making them see that connection and see how enriching and engaging it can be for them to stretch themselves a little bit. And the second thing we found is that we probably need to do a better job, or help the schools do a better job, of communicating those opportunities to parents and students. So those were our two significant findings. We did find several positive things as well. It increased collaboration among the teachers. The things that the kids did do were very exciting in a lot of ways. They enjoyed sharing them. It gave them an opportunity to present in front of their peers, et cetera, et cetera. Anything to add, Mark?
I would just say going forward, in our curriculum work that we're doing, as it pertains to social studies, I have the committees together, and on the document, it has extension and enrichment, and we're going to be reviewing, and here's this opportunity, because I do have members on my committee from all five middle schools, that they can bring their best ideas together, and we can get some consistency across the district in what we're asking our kids to do in these enrichment activities.
Okay, are there questions?
No.
Anybody?
It's my turn.
Okay, Sarah?
For I'm going to speak for science. We're going to try to incorporate as much as we can into our curriculum document writing, and then we will continue to monitor how those curriculum documents are using throughout next year. So end of quarter, end of semester, we'll set up some times to check in with all of the teachers about all of the curriculum documents, including the enrichment pieces that we've added in.
Did social studies?
That process is the same.
Right, and that is absolutely something that has to be a topic of our committees, our design committees that meet, and it is, we have an outline of the kinds of things that need to go into those curriculum documents, and that is a piece of that. So the design teams will definitely approach that.
But we don't have, so do we have any ideas or strategies other than just say it's a concern? I guess I'm looking at going on, it's a concern, like.
Yep.
We have lots of ideas for strategies, but it will definitely be a design team. I mean, Chris isn't going to say, do this, do this, do this. The team is going to help develop those things.
I think, Sarah, me, what you're asking, as well as I recall from the high school level, the counselors have to be a very key advocate, support of helping students understand that they can do these things. They absolutely can do these things for the honest credits. And a part is that communication piece. So again, not only communicating within the building to the school principals to take the active ownership in there, but also to the school counselors, and ensuring that parents are receiving the information and ensuring that communication loop is being closed. That's vital. If we don't close that loop, then students potentially could be left out.
And you have shared materials through that curriculum committee with me, too. You've shared that really nice book that has great strategies that will definitely be part of the design team. And we have the nice videotape that we can use to of Sarah's classroom that we can use as a teaching model for teachers. So we're definitely on the path to greatness in terms of honors.
Other questions or comments? I just have one of the things, and I'm glad to hear this conversation, because I think this is an opportunity for students who've never taken honors classes or thought they could take honors classes, and we need to be sure they know they can, and we need to be sure that we know there are opportunities for them to excel in maybe areas they've never had the opportunity to do that before. But sometimes it's just letting them know it's a possibility. They don't believe in themselves enough. And our teachers do a really good job of trying to approach those kids in that way. And I think we'll see that grow for that reason. Thank you. Any other things about that? Okay, the next item then is the summer school update. Dr. Manji.
Madam Chairman, Dr. Sue is here, and Deb Giorno is in the audience. Deb, if you'd like to
come forward, Deb. Again, thank you, Madam Chair, members of the committee. This definitely was an informational update request. And so what we've done is we've included our November 2013 report that highlighted all that was going to happen for this coming school year at each of the elementary, middle, and high school level. Right on the first page of the report, though, there are five bullets that as of November, the request was, what are we doing between, obviously, you know, December and now? And so just point out those five bullets. Currently, training for middle school teachers on the problem-based learning process has been done. Ongoing summer communication regarding parent letters and student registration, again, that has been completed. Currently, principals and schools are in that process of interviewing and hiring summer school staff, and training for the elementary teachers on the inquiry process, again, which we explained in November, what was going to be going on at the elementary level. And then finally, training for high school credit recovery teachers on the Compass Learning Odyssey here in June. So just the request was an informational update of what we're doing this semester.
Questions or comments from committee on the summer school update? Okay, I think the information is there, but if you have questions, again, just forward them so we can address them at another time. And last item, talent development. Thank you, Deb. Talent development program update. Dr. Manji.
Dr. Sue and Dave Tuttle are here. Dave, welcome.
Again, thank you, Madam Chair, members of the committee. This is another informational update, but it's a very vital informational update. And I know that Mr. Tuttle, along working with DPI representation and members of Teaching and Learning, has put in numerous hours to help you understand a little bit more about the talented and development and the gifted education in Kenosha, as well as he would like to move forward and just want to provide an update of how he's going to operate. And we were seeking feedback from the standing committee. So he has a nice PowerPoint as well, but regarding our piece tonight, Dave, maybe just a few words, and then we will do that the full board in June.
Let's see. Oops, there we go. One of the things I guess I would really like to push forward was that we had the opportunity to have Christina Mirsky from DPI come down and visit with us. She spent quite a bit of time with us. We looked at our district policies, our district plan. We had some conversation about some changes at the state level, not in terms of state statutes, but in terms of actually philosophy. And it's a philosophy nationwide that is really starting to overtake the gifted education, and that is to use an RTI model. We would like to proceed with that, and obviously what we have currently in place is a long-range plan from 2006. In speaking with Chris, one of the things she said is that if our district would be audited by DPI, what they would do is to look at the last board-approved plan, and that is your plan for your district. And obviously our plan took place back in 2006 and was really never fully implemented. A number of things started to progress, and then due to budget cuts, due to staffing cuts, a lot of things got eliminated, a lot of things never took place, never got implemented. And so we're really at that point where we need to really look at that plan in more detail and also see if it still is consistent with what some of the new philosophy is at the state level. And so that's really what I'd like to do, is to really get into doing that and really starting to look at that in more detail. One of the things that would be done at the state level is they would complete what's called a gap analysis chart. We actually took a look at that chart. We sat down with Chris, some of the content coordinators were there as well, and we talked about some of the pieces of it. It's really something that should be done by a larger committee so that you get several voices involved in it and take a look at it from a lot of different perspectives. But it would really allow us to also go back and look at our long-range plan, see if there are pieces there that maybe no longer really apply or really could be modified or changed a little bit. And so that's really where I would like to see this go from this point on, is to take a look at our plan, see where we're at, what needs to be done, and how things have really changed in terms of philosophy nationwide.
Are you asking the president to form a committee for gifted and talented?
Well, we were going to reach out through our process of, you know, either communication with principals, community members. We've done it at the math ad hoc. I mean, you're more than welcome to, but we know that we can advertise it and we'll get active participants. So we're fine if we reach out.
All right. Any questions or comments from the committee? Yes, Sarah.
Hard to tell. Now it's on. I just noticed when I looked at the 2000 plan, I looked at the definition of gifted, that giftedness talks about art and creativity. And when I looked at the plan, it seemed like it was mostly math, English, math, English, math, English, AP. And I was just realizing that it feels like we missed part of the definition of gifted. And I just didn't know if that was because the definition of the state has changed in the past 8 years or something else. And that might be in the PowerPoint. That
it actually was in the PowerPoint. There's, yeah, and I do have copies of the PowerPoint if you'd like them. But it is in the PowerPoint. There are two different definitions that we really utilize. One is from the National Association of Gifted Children. That definition is slightly different than what has occurred from the federal definition, which comes out of the Javits Act. And the Javits Act is what provides the federal funding, which is very minimal. But both of those definitions do have some components in it where they look at a variety of different areas, not just intellectual or academic.
Other questions or comments? Okay, thank you. Are there items that you would like to see on the future agenda? And like I said, we will have these reports and presentations at the full board meeting in June, so they will be available then.
Madam Chair, we have one that we're going to bring forward. It's a Spanish for Spanish speakers course. There was one in 2011, and it expired the way the report was written in 2013. So we have to, we want to bring forth a course proposal for that.
Okay. Anything else or any suggestions from committee members? Okay, thank you. This meeting is adjourned. Thank you very much for coming. And thank you for some of you giving up your evening to be here.
Yeah. In case you didn't know that. No, it's good though. It'll be a deal.